Oh, dear me. I don't want to alarm you, Dr. Crane, but I'm getting a very strong vibration off this.
Oh, dear God.
I can see Mrs. Crane. She's waving this poker around and screaming, "You thief! Get out! You'll never get away with this!"
Wait. No, I remember. That's what she said to the decorator when he tried to double bill her for the andirons.
I was wondering why the intruder was wearing toreador pants.
Yeah, Mike, I'm still here. Yeah, that's right. She's been missing 3 days.
Excuse me. She's been missing for 3 days and you're just panic-stricken now?
Well, I only just realized it. The last two nights, I knocked on Maris's bedroom door to wish her good night, and I was greeted with a chilly silence, so naturally I assumed everything was status quo.
Thin. Make that very thin. Caucasian. Very Caucasian.
Oh, God, what could be happening to her?
Oh, wait, wait, you got something? Okay. Uh-huh. Okay. Mike ran a check on Maris's credit cards. There's been a whole bunch of charges in New York.
Oh, God. She's been kidnapped. Someone's using her credit cards.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, all right. Slow down. Armani. Valentino. Cartier. Tiffany.
Any restaurants?
Any restaurants? Not a one.
She's alive! Oh,
no.
You're certain?
Oh, yes. From that list, she's recreating her infamous Sakes Alive, I'm 35 shopping spree.
Okay, Mike, thanks a lot. Yeah, I owe you. Bye.
Oh, Dr. Crane, I'm so relieved.
Oh, so am I. And I'm exhausted. I was so scared. Frasier, what's wrong? You look positively uncelebratory. Aren't you glad Maris is okay?
Of course I am. It's just that... Well, here you are, all panic-stricken and scared to death, and she's off on some shopping trip. Don't you find that the least bit upsetting?
Yes, I suppose her behavior was a tad inconsiderate.
Well, she left without so much as a note or a phone call.
Frasier, stay out of this. It's between Niles and his wife.
You know, I'm sorry, Dad. This is not the first time we've experienced Maris's selfish behavior. She always puts her needs above his. She never attends family functions. Doesn't that make you angry?
Well, over the years, I've learned to accept Maris's eccentricities.
Oh, she's not being eccentric. She's being arrogant and selfish.
If he says he's not angry, he's not angry.
And even if I were angry, what would you have me do?
Let it out!
Well, I am letting it out. I'm getting hives.
Well, that is a triumph of self-expression. My God, man, why don't you just let out some of the words that you're dying to say?
Oh, God, I am so sick of you and your relentless psychobabble.
Ah-ha! You're not angry at me. That was directed at Maris.
Nope, that was for you.
This is for Maris.
Oh, okay, all right, Niles. Now you got it out of your system.
Yes, but it felt so good. Let me do one more.
All right, Niles, this is good. Oh, this is healthy. But you've got to channel it. You must talk to Maris.
Oh, oh no, wait! That's beautiful. Here, this one's hideous.
Hey, I gave him that for a wedding present.
Oh, all right, here.
Gosh, Neil!
What? Oh, Martha, this feels wonderful. Oh, you must try it. I meant at your house.
Oh, my God, it's Maris.
What?
What? Maris?
You said she was in New York.
No, I didn't know. She probably
said she was in New York. All right, all right. No one panic. There's an easy solution for this. Frasier, bash me on the head with this. We'll tell Maris there was a break-in.
Niles.
Stop it.
God, you are the damaged party here, not Maris.
But the mess.
This mess is the physical manifestation of years of repressed anger. Time to draw a line in the sand and say, I have had enough. My God, man, show her your mess.
You're right. It's time I told Maris I will not tolerate this behavior. I'm going out there and I'm going to demand an apology.
Good for you. I always hated that dynasty.